and IndyCar bigwigs resolve years of bad blood. Robin Miller joins us to break down what unification means. After a week of bumping, banging, and bending the rules, NASCAR takes all three shows west to California. He went up in flames in Pomona.
Where we make our living, man, right?
But Tony Pedregon's ready to rise up in Phoenix and prove there's more than one comeback kid in the NHRA. Derailed in Houston, ready to redeem in Atlanta. Chad Reed wants to be the next Supercross hero. He better step on it soon. The speed.
I think it's incumbent upon, you know, teams, sanctioning body, you know, all constituencies. It's incumbent upon everybody to take advantage of this and build it into, you know, keep this momentum alive. Everybody's sure excited it's back together. Let's make something of it now.
And with that, welcome to the Speed Report, where our top story is manna from heaven for fans of open-wheel racing here in America. Because after 12 years of what the Pentagon might call mutually assured destruction, the split between Champ Car and the Indy cars appears to be over. Hi, everybody. I'm Bob Varsha.
I'm Ralph Sheheen. Now, Bob, are you sure? I mean, you and I have been friends for a long time. You're not kidding or pulling my leg, are you?
I read it somewhere. Yeah, right here. It says it's over.
Well, we've heard this for about 20 times before, but apparently it's for real. And here's what the players are saying.
Well, I think the unification is very, very positive for the sport. I've said that before. I know a number of people have tried to put that together over the last three or four years, but I've got to take my hat off to Tony George, who persevered, and certainly Kevin Kalkoven and Jerry Forsyth came to the table, and I think the support for the teams coming over and the unification will be terrific.
It's pretty tough on Champ Car teams, you know, 1 month before the first race. We haven't got any cars and, you know, we don't know much about these cars, and these other guys have run them for 6 years. But that's a part of the deal, and I think it's going to be a much better series.
You know, compliments to all the Champ Car teams and everyone involved to make this happen so late in 2008, because it's going to be tough for them this year. And it's a sacrifice for them to come over and race with us at a disadvantage, not having as much experience on Dallara's and most of the circuits we race at.
You'd be hard-pressed to find anybody that isn't excited about this. You know, there's gonna be a lot of hard work on behalf of the Champ Car teams, but it's going to be very positive for open wheel.
Well, you don't build overnight and you don't lose overnight. I think it's going to take time for this sport to get where it needs to be. But, you know, a lot of great racing people came from open wheel racing. You know, look at Tony Stewart, look at Jeff Gordon, and people that have really moved on to bigger heights in their careers. So I see this as a tremendous opportunity.
Now, as you'd expect, the consensus is very positive about unification. Robin Miller broke this story for SpeedTV.com. He's here to discuss the implications with us, as well as with Dave Despain on Wind Tunnel tonight. Robin, the two sides are calling this an agreement in principle to go racing right away. What do we know about the details?
We're still speculating about the details, Bobby, because there's no official release. But what we think is going to happen is if you sign the document and you promise, and you're a Champ Car team and you promise to run Long Beach, you'll get two free Dallara's for every Champ Car you show up with at Long Beach, because obviously they need a field there. You'll get a free Honda engine lease, and then you'll get $1.2 million per car, which if you're a two-car team, that's a pretty good start, $2.4 million. At least it pays your engine bill and or your tire bill and some expenses. But I think what we don't know for sure yet is where all the races fit in.
Do we have any idea, Robin, what the schedule is going to look like?
And I think what you got to say is, Ralph, Long Beach and Motegi, that's the big thing. They're going to race on the same week in April 20th right now. What's going to happen there? It looks like there's going to be two races. Edmonton's probably going to be pushed back a week from its original schedule, so it doesn't bump up against Mid-Ohio. And Australia, Surfers Paradise, is in, providing it's not an exhibition race. Because right now, the IRL is contracted to say the season's got to end in September at Chicagoland Speedway. The IRL is not really wild about ending the season 3 months later on the other side of the world at 3 o'clock in the morning, but they don't want to lose Surfers Paradise.
Well, obviously, there's a lot of positives in this. What are some of the negatives?
I'd say the negatives are the Atlantic Series, first and foremost. Is it going to be able to stay alive? There were 25 cars at Sebring testing, and they got some pretty good drivers, some young Americans that want to move up. Vince O'Connor says, yep, we're going to be able to keep it. We got a couple of backup plans. We can't tell you yet. Secondly, Cosworth, 30 employees, they probably lost their job unless they can find something right away. And Champ Car, 45 out of 50 people, including, not including the safety team, which is probably, you know, the safety team is the pioneers of safety in this whole organization.
Yeah. Well, while we're on the subject of people losing jobs, if you put the two team rosters together, we're looking at what, 35, 36 teams, probably too many for any one race this side of Indy. How many do we realistically expect will survive the eventual shakeout?
I think, Bobby, they'd be thrilled if they had 24 to 26 cars on every IRL grid except Indy. And I think in Indy, we got a chance maybe to get 40 or 42 cars going for 33 spots where bumping actually means something again. The other thing is, how's this thing going to look in 2009? How many of these little guys are going to be able to survive? And I think the jury's out, but I think at least this offer is generous enough to give people a fighting chance.
Well, we're going to take a pause here for a moment. As I mentioned, Robin will join Dave Despain on Wind Tunnel tonight. Who else will weigh in on this whole unification story, Dave?
Well, Bob, first of all, I'm hoping Robin didn't give you all his good stuff. But even if he did, I think we're okay, because we're going to have Tony George and Kevin Kalkoven, the two principals in this deal, to answer many of the questions you've just asked and a whole lot more. Mario Andretti, a superstar in the cockpit, and since then, an advocate of and negotiator, in some cases, toward this unification deal that has finally been done. We'll get his take. And we're going to talk to Jacques Villeneuve, not only the last kart champion before the split, but also an aspiring NASCAR driver. We want him to weigh in on both those issues. What does he think about unification, and what the heck is going on with his NASCAR career? Finally, Bobby Labonte. His late model driver got KO'd. How might that help local racers all over America? Guys?
Well, Dave, good luck cramming all that into 1 hour. Be sure to join Dave, Robin, and their guests tonight at 9 Eastern. And while we're on the subject of unification, we do expect series officials to have a formal and more detailed announcement later this week.